A question I'm often asked is how to paint Aetherwing feathers and those really bright colour schemes that you can see on the box. So today we're going to show you how to do the blue colour scheme for these. But you could of course do different colour schemes if you wanted to by just adding in some different colours to the method. But what you want to do first of all is undercoat your miniature using Mechanica Standard Grey Spray, which will both prime your miniature and give an excellent base colour to work from. And then what we're going to do is paint all the feathers using Cantor Blue and then pick out some of them with Sotek Green and then Baharoth Blue. Now after this we'll shade the entire miniature with Druki Violet and then start to highlight by dry brushing. So for this we'll go back to Sotek Green first of all, followed by Baharoth Blue, and then finally very lightly with Pallid Witch Flesh. So to begin with then, we're going to start with Cantor Blue, which I'm going to be applying using a large base brush. And what you want to do is, as always, thinly paint with just a little bit of water so it's nice and smooth. And when you're ready, all you've got to do is start painting all your feathers with this colour. And with this colour, you will need to apply two thin coats. Next, it's time to add some Sotek Green to the feathers, and you can do whichever ones you want here to make different patterns, but I'm going to go for this band running along here and a small amount at the base just down here as well. Now, at this stage, it's also a good idea to do some on the chest. Now, the area I'm talking about here is around the face, just up to around there, and then partway down to about here. We're now ready to add some Baharoth Blue to our pattern. So this time I'm going to be applying it towards the end of the feathers, such as along here. And I'm going to be applying two thin coats of this colour, going all along this part. And I'm going to be doing these longer feathers down here too. And once again, it's a good idea to add a little bit to the face. So I'm going to be adding some just around this point, I think this time. Now that we've applied all those colours, we're ready to shade them using Druki Violet. And you want to paint this all over the feathers. The shade's now completely dry and you will notice it will go a little bit blotchy on some of the flatter parts, but don't worry about that because we will neaten it up as we highlight, which is what we're going to start doing now, starting with Sotek Green, which I'm going to dry brush on, and I'm focusing this on just the parts we originally painted with Sotek Green and also Cantor Blue. The difference is I'm just going to be a little bit heavier on the Sotek Green parts than I am on the Cantor Blue parts. I've finished building up that Sotek Green now, and you can see how it's got rid of those splodges on the feathers nicely. And now we're ready to do much the same thing on Baharoth Blue this time. As before, you want to focus mostly on the parts that you've already painted with Baharoth Blue, just to even these parts out. And just get lighter as you work your way up the wings. So light on the Sotek Green parts, and especially light on the Cantor Blue parts. And then finish off with a very light dry brush of Pallid Witch Flesh on all the lighter feathers. And also, be sure to pick out all the most defined features on the rest of the body as well with this colour. For example, just along the front of the wings. And there we are, that's all the blue feathers of this Aetherwing completed. And by just changing some of those colours, you can get some really nice, bright, colourful combinations. But I hope you found that interesting, and we'll see you all again soon.